first, a little introduction. Marine ecosystem service, they provide us goods such as raw material, genetic material, services, pollution control, and cultural benefits, so to assure this marine ecosystem service to the next generations. However, population growth, the cost of development, the pollution, and anthropogenic activities are degrading the marine ecosystem service that most of the countries depend on. So now you might ask, where does SPI fit in the middle of all of this, right? So I'm going to tell you. SPI is a non-disturbance technique. It can take pictures of the first 20 centimeters of sediment, and I'm sorry for this, but I need to. And with these pictures, we can extract biological, chemical, and physical features. It's also a very quick sampling. In 1 hour, we can have 100 pictures, which is really good. However, not so good for me that was analyzing the pictures. That was my work. So over here, you can see the SPI is out of the deck, is going to sink, and now in 20 seconds, it's going to take a first picture, and after these 20 seconds, a second picture, due to quality control. With these pictures, we can do impact assessment. So this was my aim. Per station, we took 3 replicates. And this is when the magic happens, the spying. And after this, we have these marvelous pictures, at least in my opinion. So now, the aim was to test the SPI, Sediment Profile Imaging tool, applicability in different anthropogenic activities in the Belgian part of the North Sea, assessing these physical, chemical, and biological parameters and SPI indices, OZ and BHQ. I'm going to refer upper. So now, case studies. One of them was FACET. FACET, the aim is to see fining or hardening of the sediment that is occurring in the Belgian part of the North Sea. The numbers are reference spots, and then BRN11 and D6NNS are the ones that we want to see what is going on. Second one, impact assessment of pulse fisheries. So here we took SPI samples before and after the treatments to see what is going on over there. So we did 3 treatments, pulse on when the electric shock is being induced, beam trawl, and pulse off. Then, for dredge disposal, we have LS1 and LS2. The difference is LS1 has a highest intensity of impact of dredge material, and LS2 is the moderate. So inside the circles, you can see its impact. Outside is control. And then I did a gradient from southwest to northeast to see if we find any changes. For last, the sand extraction areas in Buttenratel, here, high and medium impact and the respects controls. And then in the Inderbanken, the same impact and control. So this is just for you to have a more or less clear idea. So, and with these pictures, the parameters that we can assess are bed forms, the mud clumps, subsurface fauna, the sediment description, for example, if it's fine, medium, RPD redox layer, how deep we can find it, the sediment-water interface, so the prism, how deep it goes, and surface fauna. Then the index, we have benthic habitat quality. It can attribute a score from 15 to from 0 to 15, where 15 is the good environmental status. After this one, we have organism-sediment index. These two are correlated one with each other. But this represents more in a stage. So stage one, it's related, for example, if the sediment is contaminated or if the redox layer is in the upper centimeters. Second stage, it's a recolonization from these benthic organisms. And for last, the third stage, it's a full recovery of the system or where we don't see RPD layer. With this RPD, sometimes I had some limitations. And I did an RPD classification, which means a SMI quantitative method. So for example, pictures with more than 50% of mud, I was using a software. And this software cannot measure the areas, these gaps, as can you see here. So only the strata layer. And with this, I assume, OK, the RPD will be somewhere else between 1 centimeter. The other way around, if the sediment, if the RPD layer or the anoxic layer is lower than 50%, OK, I will assume 3.5. So these values are based in tables where the previous index are based on. So and also, this is more like a feature of a stage one, and that more like a stage two. Then oxygenized reduced layer, for example, imagine the prism, when it's digging in, it only can go until 3 centimeters, and we don't see the RPD layer. So with this, I assume 5 centimeters. OK. Then the other way around, if the prism goes until 10 centimeters, I will assume, OK, I don't see RPD here neither. So I will assume the average of the penetration, so the prism, when it goes down. Normal measurement, OK, wherever I see the RPD, I will use it, of course. So the parameters applicability. For sediment class and prism penetration, I noticed that it works for the different case studies. The bed forms also, not for sand extraction, because the environment in sand extraction, it's in a completely change. And it's really complicated to see reliable information here. Then mud clumps, we only were interested to see in dredge disposal areas. Fauna, we did in every place, but not in face it, because it was just fining and hardening. RPD layer and the BHQ cannot be used. However, I can suggest some adaptations. And for the OZ, cannot be used. So now I'm going to be a little more OK. So sediment class. In all of the pictures that I took, this is just some examples, I found finding of the sediment in the sand extraction. So where, according to papers, were supposed to be medium and previous works, now the sediment is fine, mainly. So this shows some traces, some signs of changings. Then for the RPD layer, this is in the case of the dredge disposal places. We have also, we can see different patterns from the LS1 and LS2. So we can see the RPD layer, it's deeper in the impact, and LS2, no. Then the gradient that I did didn't show any relevant information. Then mud clumps. So for the mud clumps, I use clusters, feel some a lot. This basically means when in the picture I see between 1 or 3 mud clumps, and then some between 3 to 5, and a lot more than 5. Here I saw a pattern, for example, impact. We can see more than in the control, but over there, no. This can be due to the moderate dredge disposal that is happening in the area. And also because the material, when the, it's being dredged in the impact area, is going to, due to current, tidal currents and wave action, is going to flow away. Surface structures is the same, with a few, some, and a lot of clusters. I found a pattern between pulse on and troll, where before the pulse in orange, we have few clusters, then we will have more. And in gray, where it was supposed to be some, the cluster's sum, will decrease. So basically, it's the other way around. So it's going to decrease due to the passage of the trolls. And yeah, that was the outcome from both of these ones. Then for fecal pellets, after every treatment, I could see in my spy pictures that maybe due to the trollings, the fecal pellets decrease in the pictures. Then the organism sediment index for fisheries. So the highest score according OZ was 11. And the quartile was always reaching the level in all of them. In the other three treatments, I'm just showing one, was always in the 11. So I was like, OK, something is not right here. I don't know what's going on. And so here we can see slightly differences, but nothing that we can rely on. So then I start thinking, and I come back to the tables where OZ is based on. So when the RPD layer is at 3.75 centimeters, it's going to attribute a score of 6. In the other hand, Then I thought, okay, all of my pictures, they didn't show a lot of surface fauna or inferred surface fauna or substructure. And most of the pictures, the RPD was deeper than 4 centimeters or 3 centimeters. So I was like, okay, so this is going to automatically attribute a stage on 3, that is 5. So 5 plus 6, 11. 11, okay, overestimation. So OZ was not working here. Then for benthic habitat quality, was the other way around. 6 is the lowest score here. And I was having, okay, I was like, okay, in the previous one, higher, now not even reaching the lowest for a good environmental status. And yeah, I don't see very, I cannot say that these results are significant or if I can even use them. But then I thought, okay, let's do the same that I did for the other index. So here, when I was analyzing all of these 1,000 pictures, I went through them and I remember feeding pit or mouth, these characteristics, I never found in any of my pictures. And also, oxid voids, I also never found in my pictures. So this is already 3 points out of those 12 points. So this would not be working in the normal scale that I was using. So for this, I suggest for future studies, since I was working just to see the tube worms, relative estimation, if I use these clusters, few, some, a lot, and I attribute score of 1, 2, and 3, maybe I can adapt this index to the necessities of the Belgian part of North Sea. The same goes for the non-sessile organisms, brittle stars, fish, starfish. They are not taken into account according to the classic indices. So, and actually, I found a lot of these creatures there. And then, for last, the mud clumps, we can also attribute a score, but the other way around. So more mud clumps will mean, okay, maybe we have disturbance here. So will be 1, and then if we have few clusters, will be 3 points. So adaptations are required, yes. For last, spy applicability was confirmed in the Belgian part of North Sea in different anthropogenic activities. Some of the parameters were more interesting for some of these case studies than probably for the others. OZ, however, cannot be applicable because it was giving an overestimation. And BHQ must be adapted to fit in the coastal area. So thank you for your attention. I want to thank to Ilbu for having me these last couple of months, to my supervisor Gert van Hooy and Han van Hossel for all the support, otherwise this would not be possible, to the embassy coordination staff, my friends, and the Erasmus Plus, and also the University of Ghent. Thank you very much for your attention.